I mean, that is the psyche of America. Here you have a case in California that further reveals the hypocrisy, Richard. Mm-hmm. The case with the boy out there, what's his name, Rodney King. They got,
I mean, anybody,
audio and video witnesses. Yeah, you don't even need no human witnesses. But yet and still, they trying to get these double-talking, backstabbing, billy club-wielding, double-talking police to talk their way out of kicking that man's ass. And they can't do that.
Nope.
They going to have to do some time. Turn it around, Richard. Turn it around. You let, I tell you what, what's Boy George's son's name? Neal Bush?
Yeah, Neal.
You let Neal, you let Neal Boy George, Neal Boy George, you let Neal Boy George Bush come out of the Omni. After a Hawks game, after drinking a couple two-minute brewskis, get in his car and get pulled over by a couple of officer Negroes and touched up like that, man, they'll fight a whole Atlanta Police Department.
I have a friend of mine, a brother lives up in Charlotte, North Carolina, that swears the next time he gets pulled over, the first thing he's going to do is hit the asphalt, start screaming and rolling around.
Right, when I get pulled over,
the only way you get out of a ticket.
First thing I'm going to do, I'm going to start beating myself up. Appreciate you calling, man. I'm going to beat myself up, man, when they pull me over. And I'm not stopping for one police either. Got to have about five police when you stop me. I am not carrying any narcotics. I am reaching into my pocket for my license. You know, that's the way to get you. Oh, look, this nigga's got dope.
Yeah, right.
233 WGST coming back to Ty
in Ben Hill. Waiting on you to check in. 1-800-FON-WGST. Hear from Maynard Jackson and Ira Jackson, Michael Jackson and Bo Jackson. Boy, I tell you, these Jacksons sure are popular. Jesse Jackson, I tell you, that's a popular black name, you know, Jackson. That's my last name, Ralph Jackson.
Let me hear your lie,
Mr. Panther to the worst fears, to the racist element.
Is it right?
To pander to the David Dukes. And the Pat Buchanan.
Is it right to write a bad check?
233-WGST, I see Steve checking in. Let's go to Steve quickly. Steve on the mobile phone, you want to talk about Heflin, Alabama. You were locked up over there too, man?
I've been there.
Have you been locked up in Heflin?
No, we were white boys and we didn't get in jail. But we were up there, I road tripped a buddy and... an fraternity from Atlanta, and pulled outside. He got out late at night to go up in the bushes because he'd been drinking beer.
Right.
And then he ran out, tried to stop cars, and this, cop showed up, and he was chewing tobacco, carrying a gun, and said, you know, we're just road tripping this guy.
Uh-huh.
And he says, well, he's interrupting people. And I says, well, we're this fraternity, we're doing this. He says, I don't know anything about fraternity or university, but he's breaking the law.
Man, they put us in jail. Then they gave me the keys to my buddy's car. They let me out. And they kept my buddy, and they gave me the keys to his car. It was a 1972 Charger in 72. And I said, I'm not taking this car nowhere. I said, I'm walking back to Atlanta. And I looked at the sheriff's wife. I said, you think they're going to bother me? Because they were downstairs eating dinner while we were in jail. She said, no, son, just go on back to Atlanta and get the money. So I went on and got the car. But I went to the burger place and brought the burgers back to the jail. And there was one white boy in there. He was real cool. And at that time, Pistol Pete Maravich was living.
Oh.
We used to call him Pistol Pete because he was real cool. And I was like playing cards with him when I was in jail, keeping their mind off of something else. But Heflin ain't no place to play, Steve.
No, sir.
All right, appreciate your call. Ty, all right, thank you. Ty, hold tight. Arthur, you'll be second. Arthur in Southeast Atlanta. Randy in Riverdale, we're going to take a news break. Over me.
It's not that I didn't want to meet my future son-in-law, but I didn't feel well because of constipation. I couldn't cancel, so I went anyway. The next day, I asked for a friend's advice. She told me she takes a fiber product.
92.
I'm going to be gone for a couple of days, off Friday and Saturday and Monday. I got Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday to work next week, so I'm going to say hi to some of these stars.
If I were your woman,
neighborhood. Let's go to the hood, to the girls in the hood. Let's go out to Peyton Forest, you know, where the forest brings up those little darling little Bambis, you know. Those little knock-kneed girls that turn into monsters, you know. Knock-kneed girls with nappy hair that you don't pay any attention to. And then you turn around 10 or 20 years later and they're bad.
If I were your woman.
Boy, if you were my woman.
If I were your woman.
And I was your man. Oh, girl.
And you were my man.
Talking about you, Joya Bayko. Joya Bayko. Nell Tricia Griffin and Sherry Griffin. Those two girls married two different dudes by the name of Johnson. Now there's Cherie Griffin Johnson and Neltricia Griffin Johnson.
Oh, and little knock-kneed Rometta. Little girl running around the neighborhood. Little knock-kneed Rometta with big eyes.
Now she's a big-time dentist, and oh, she's a star. Dr. Rometta Powell.
Ooh. If you were my woman, girl. If I had a dentist for a wife. Oh, if you were my woman.
And the judge had a daughter over there in the neighborhood. Judge Webster, Judge Isabella Webster, had a beautiful daughter. And she's grown now, and she's a star, yeah. Karen Webster. Oh, and look, my little baby sister, Kim Smith Norman, she turned out to be a star. Diane Henry, Hope Jackson, and Pam Jackson, and oh, Tanya Rozier. Now, that's just in Peyton Forest. That's just on southwest side of town, you know?
Oh, girl.
I'm what you need. Oh, Lord.
Star Watch.
Yeah, Lynn Spiller down there at Citizens Trust Bank. Kendall Johnson at Riches. Alicia Taylor working for Hosea's daughter. Naomi Bell working for Herman Russell. And China Nelson working for Ron Wilson. Oh, China. China. Well, that's a name. That's a name for a woman. China. China Nelson. Oh, Lord.
Betty Turner. Yvonne Brinkley. Karen Greer. Dangerous Sandra Bookman.
Oh, and my baby. My baby. Donna Lowry.
Donna.
Oh, Donna. Say it, Donna. My sweet loving Donna. Donna Lowry. This is the Ralph Rubin Hill Star Watch, brought to you by the Talk How You Like Underground Posse. I can dream. I can dream.
Hey. Hey, Ty.
Hi.
How are you?
Hi. You're talking a lot of wind.
Hey, Ty.
Hey.
Ty in Ben Hill.
How's everything going, Ty?
Fine.
How you been?
Fine.
What, you're not supposed to be on the phone? Are you sneaking and talking to me? You got your hand
no,
all over?
No, I wouldn't do nothing like that.
Okay. Tell me what's happening on your end of Ben Hill. I got my end covered. What's happening on your end?
Nothing much.
I thought you had some hot news for me when you checked in. You've been on hold 30 minutes. What they doing at your school?
They're finna get ready to have some kind of free day tomorrow. They don't have work on Friday.
Free day? You don't have to go to school on Friday?
No, you go there, but they have sign language and all kinds of different stuff.
Oh, they sure changing y'all. Y'all need to work 6 and 7 days a week. You know, the Japanese go to school all year round.
So we stay in till 4 o'clock.
Oh, but you're not doing that, so they're just going to babysit y'all tomorrow. Well, you tell them I said, hey. Okay, let me hear you say hey one time, huh? By Ty. Ty had been here, a 13-year-old caller. She started calling when she was like 8. She stayed on hold till she was 10, and, you know, we've been talking for about 2 years. Let's go to Arthur in Southeast Atlanta. You're on News Radio 640 WGST.
A couple of things started at the top. Now, you were talking about the cocaine in Peru.
Yes, sir.
I don't know if you saw the small article in the paper a couple of days ago where the son of someone connected with Dean Witter.
Yeah.
Well, I think it was Dean Witter's son.
Okay.
Is being charged with laundering money.
Yeah.
It was a small article about two or three.
Yeah. I leave my TV at my bedside on all night, and I catch that ABC overnight stuff, and I heard that, and it plants it in my subconscious, and when something kind of sticks in my subconscious, I'll follow it up the next day in the newsroom, and I pull that piece of information out of the bucket, and that's exactly what happened.
Mm. So then you're talking about the
big money.
You always talk about the fellas in
the project. Right.
But this guy who's watching, I don't know how many millions of dollars.
Did you see the movie, what was that movie with Al Pacino? Scarface. Did you see Scarface?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Did you see him going to the bank with those duffel bags of money? I'm serious. They had to get like they had to get vans to take the money to the bank. You know, you see the movie New Jack City, how they had those big bushel laundry baskets full of dollars and fives and tens and twenties, and they were like giving away the ones because they didn't feel like counting them. That's how much money is in cocaine.
Oh yeah. One quick comment about the producer of New Jack City and House Party. You know, New Jack City got all the publicity, how the scenes about blacks being in the neighborhood and the type of movie it was. But House Party was I think the director of both movies? Wasn't the director of both movies, New Jack City and House Party?
The director of New Jack City was Mario Van Peebles. I don't think Mario Van Peebles was the director of House Party.
No, he wasn't the
producer?
But the producer.
Okay, I'm not familiar.
The producer of New Jack City and House Party were the same.
Okay.
But you never saw any poor publicity about House Party.
No.
Nor the amount of money that it made. Now, House Party was tops on the list for, 4 or 5 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
And all the money they made, I think the producer of both films was black. And now they're screaming about Spike Lee going $5 million over budget. And on one quick thing, and I'm going to let you go.
I'm going to holler at you about that Spike Lee thing, too, but go ahead.
Yeah, no. The other thing is that this movie was made some time ago, Sophisticated Gents by Melvin Van Peebles.
Yeah, that's Mario's dad. I was in a couple of plays by him. Ain't supposed to die natural death.
Yeah. Mm. But the thing about it, CBS hired him to do this movie, mm-hmm. made for television.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I was living in New York at the time,
mm-hmm.
and you know how they have these screenings, and they invite you to these screenings?
Yeah.
I think it was about 50 or 75 people went in this room. We saw it, and we had to rate it. And I think there were about 10 or 12 blacks.
Mm-hmm.
Now, every person gave this movie an excellent rating, and later, I met some fellow that I knew who worked in the division of CBS. And I said, what happened to
Sophisticated
the movie?
Uh-huh.
He said, Sophisticated? He said, well, it didn't sell. And I said, what do you mean it didn't sell? He said, it didn't show you guys in the proper light.
That's the way it is. Well, I tell you what, speaking of proper light, Arthur, John Singleton's Boys in the Hood has gone on sale this week in the on the market in terms of the videos. You know, you can go get the VCR. Boys in the Hood, that Columbia TriStar movie. They don't have the suggested retail price for it, but they gave him some good publicity in Steve Murray's column today in Video Watch. He says that rated R. Citizen Kane, it's not, but you'll see why 23-year-old writer-director John Singleton replaces Orson Welles as the youngest nominee ever for a Best Director Oscar. He's also the first African-American candidate for that award. In Mr. Singleton's directing debut, you'll see this little boy, Cuba Gooding Jr., playing a high school senior in South Central L.A. Despite the guidance of his super dad, played by my main man Larry Fishburne, he and his best friends Ice Cube and Morris Chestnut find themselves lured toward the chaos of gang warfare, a street mixture of smart character studies and whatnot. This is a message flick. People need to go out and check it out. Boys in the Hood. I told you when it came out, it was going to be a monster, you know? Boys in the Hood. Streetlight. That's what it is. 233 WGST. When I come back, we got my African Muslim brother, Abbahdeen and Vinings. 233 WGST. I'm out of here at 10 o'clock until next Tuesday, my people. If you want to talk to me, talk now or forever. Hold your peace. 233 WGST. Every time a light goes on down here, an angel gets their wings, you know? This is a wonderful life. I'm going to go out here and jump in this cold water, you know? 233 WGST. 1-800-FON-WGST. I command one of my stars to call me. I just gave y'all all that play. One of my stars. So the Star Watch update, give me a call right now. One of my girls, Sean Robinson, give me a call right now. Call me from Milwaukee, girl.
Robinson. How are you?
Oh, baby, I'm great, baby. 233, that was Sean checking in. Check in, Nicole Roche. Haven't heard from you in a little while. Tanya Rose, you check in. Joy Baco, check in. Romella Powell, check in. Win some of these boat show tickets. 233 WGST. 1-800-FON-WGST. Yeah.
Gonna do. I'm gonna take you over to Meat World and let you pick out 99 cents worth of chicken breast. They're 99 cents a pound. You can get beef ribs for 89 cents a pound, chicken wings, and cook them up buffalo style, 43 cents a pound. These are fresh wings, not frozen. But there's nothing wrong with frozen food, especially when it's freshly frozen fish. And they've got breaded fillets of perch or flounder at Meat World, three locations, for 89 cents a pound. Let me tell you where Meat World is located, because they are packed. And I'm gonna be honest with you. When I do a commercial, I put my heart and soul into it. No matter who I tell you to go to, I check them out and I put my name and the station's name and everything out on the line. I went to Meat World and they are strong on Cleveland Avenue, right at I-75 across from the Kmart. They are strong on Lee Street, right down from Fort McPherson and Camerton Road, and they are strong on Bankhead Highway. Meat World! Meat World! Meat World!
Atlanta's most accurate severe weather forecasts from America's most accurate weather service, the Weather Channel, exclusively on News Radio 640 WGST.
We got a winner. We got a winner. Adam on a mobile phone. Bring him up, George. Bring him up. He got Wes on the run. He got Wes on the run. Adam on a mobile phone. Did you tell him to get out of town?
Absolutely. He didn't catch me in the delay.
Okay, I tell you what. I'm gonna feed you.
He cut me off right in the middle of the sucker.
All right. Now, if I can... You said sucker?
He cut me off right in the middle of the sucker.
Oh, okay. Well, how did you say it? Let me just get an instant replay.
I just said, from WGST, get up! Oh, sucker. He cut me off right in the suck.
Okay. Oh, right in the suck. Well, listen.
He cut me off.
If I can get a verification on this, Adam, Liz, I want you to...
I got it on tape.
All right, let's put him on hold. Get his name and address and everything.
I got it on tape. And, you know, I tried to do it three ways.
Okay. Now, where do you stay?
Where?
Uh-huh.
In Gwinnett County.
Man, I'm going to feed you. It's going to be hard to get you to come in town. Do you work in town?
Absolutely. I'm in town right now, sitting outside the Fox Theater, waiting for the family to get out of Alvinelli.
Yeah. Did they get those tickets from me?
No. No, but...
How much were those tickets, by the way?
Oh, man, they were expensive, but you know, it's a good show.
Excellent. It's excellent exposure for your family, too, man. It's beautiful, mm-hmm. man. That's culture. That's part of our ethnicity. That's part of our contribution. Speaking of contribution, I'm going to feed you. Let's get his name, Liz. Get his number. We get some verification. He told Miss Weston split. Oh, let me get my star watchee on from Riverdale. You're on News Radio 640 WGST.
How are you doing, Ralph?
Oh, Lord, Evonne, my baby. I miss you so much, darling.
I miss you, too.
I miss you, baby, because ever since Rich has moved, you know, you look so good when you go out walking. Can I tell the audience how I met you?
Yes.
Okay, well, I first met Evonne, like, walking around downtown. She was, like, out on her lunch break with this fiery red hair and these stockings and things, and had some titty shoes on. And then one thing led to another. We did a little lunch. Unfortunately, there's a man by the name of Leon in your life, right?
Unfortunately.
Oh, that's cold. But I sure miss you, darling.
Yes, kid.
I miss you.
I miss seeing you, too.
Well, listen, I might come by there. I'm going to be downtown putting some clothes in the cleaners, and I might have to holler at you. Are you still down there in the dungeon over there at Nations Bank?
Yes, sir. They finna kick us out of the dungeon.
Where y'all going?
Well, wherever we can find a place.
So CNS has changed the name, but you're still on the corner of Mitchell Street and Forsyth. Okay.
Uh-huh.
Well, so you still taking lunch. What about Lowrider? How is she doing?
She's still riding low.
She's still riding low. That's cold.
But High Rider has moved on.
High Rider is gone. My girl, Brenda?
Alvinese.
Oh, Alvinese.
She's still with the thing, but she's at another branch.
Well, I'm so glad you checked in. And is it true, Evonne, that not only you're from the country, but is it true that, and by the way, it was a girl looked just like you last night at the Omni. I like to fell out my seat. I thought it was you. Well, I haven't seen you at the Omni either. But is it true that Vicky Long used to live next door to you?
Not right next door, but very close in the neighborhood across the street.
Well, darling, I'm so glad you checked in, and thank you for listening.
I'm glad I did, too. I listen to you all the time, but
tell
I took the time out to call. That's all I needed was your go-ahead to call,
that's
honey.
Right. Well, tell Leon I said go get a six-pack of that Bull, drink all six of them cans, and go the wrong way down 75.
I'll tell him.
Bye, baby. Good to hear from you.
Okay.
Oh,
care.
Okay, darling. Star Watch. Well, my stars checked in. When you have...
Daddy, I like your show. Ralph, can I have your autograph?
One of the greatest entertainers of all time. Not me, not me, no, no, not me. Stevie Wonder. That's right. And Aisha. Isn't she lovely? Why, Stevie's bad. Stevie and Yolanda, they had the baby, and then he made a record about it, you know?
Isn't she lovely? Isn't she wonderful?
Yes, sir. I got two beautiful daughters.
Isn't she precious?
Two precious straight-A girls. One made all S's, the other one made all A's. All S's and all checks. Oh, look, girl.
Isn't she lovely, neighbor?
I got my son out the way first, you know, and then boom, I dropped two girls. I'm serious, man. See, I know the formula, and I was told this formula by some old black man. If you want to have a boy, you got to hold your mouth like this. If you want to have a girl, you hold your mouth like this. So, yeah, I got confused the second time when I held my mouth like, Abbahdeen, Vinings, you're on News Radio 640 WGST.
Hello, Ross.
Hey, my brother.
How are you?
Doing fine.
Were you trying to avoid me?
No, sir.
Are you sure?
If I was trying to avoid you, I'd do this. Captain Pierre, you're on News Radio 640 WGST.
Assalamu alaikum, Ross.
Wa alaikum assalamu alaikum.
Enjoying your show, man.
Thank
Haven't
you,
heard
you
in a couple of weeks.
Appreciate it.
Brother been out of town.
Yeah, where you been? Upstate, downstate?
A little bit of both. I went to Kentucky and Nashville.
What part of Kentucky?
Bowling Green.
Bowling Green. Don't know nobody in Bowling Green. What,
yeah.
What part of Tennessee? Nashville?
Yeah, I went to Nashville.
Nasty Nashville. Does
yeah,
it still
Nashville.
Smell like coal up there?
Huh?
Does it still smell like coal?
Yeah, it's still a little funny smell in the air.
How much time have you spent in Nashville, Tennessee?
About 4 days.
Is
know,
it a lake?
The longest time
is
spent.
It a big lake near Nashville? I remember visiting a friend after we finished school, and then he took me to a nice lake that's kind of like Lake Lanier is, you know, like Lake Lanier is to Atlanta. There's a big lake near Nashville.
No.
You ain't familiar with it?
I ain't familiar
with
that.
So what's up?
What's up? Just checking in.
Captain
of the Underground Posse.
There you go.
Pierre,
downtown, living large. You been down to Kenny's Alley before and after the Hawks games, man, they trying to crank up Underground. You been through
yeah,
there?
Yeah, I've been down there. I went to the Pacers game last Friday.
Right.
I stepped through that for a minute.
Man, they lost six straight. What is it? Seven straight now, right?
Yeah, seven
and
straight.
And Clyde the Glide and the Duck Man coming in town this weekend.
Oh,
what?
Yeah, that's right.
Don't look
give me free tickets.
Let me get any tickets, Liz. We do? Are you serious? Free tickets to the boat show? You talking about tickets to the game. See, you out there jumping up and down. Yeah, we got free tickets. We got free tickets. We got tickets to the boat show, man, if you're a boating man. But
no,
unfortunately.
I'm straight. I'm going to have to pass on that one.
Yeah, well, I'll get you in one of them games, player. I'll get you in. How many tickets you going to need?
Two of them.
Liz, take his name down off the air. And what I'm going to do, I got a friend over in the ticket department at the Omni.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I got to beg now, so I'm going to beg. You're going to have to buy me some refreshments when I get you up in the game.
Okay,
now.
I'll do that.
All right,
mad at you, though, man.
You're going to be sitting next to Dion and Evonne and them. We had to put you in the celebrity seats, these celebrity tickets.
Oh, okay,
so,
man.
I'm going to call and get you a deuce now.
Okay, so she's going to take my name and number, right?
Yeah, we're going to put you home. But why are you mad at me, player? I might not give you the ticket. What's
up? Man, you ain't give me your autograph when I saw you, man.
Man, I don't play that, man. Who am I? I'm just a talk show host, man. I pay income tax just like you. I put my pants on one leg at a time, man. I ain't Ted Turner or Dominique, man. I don't be giving up no autographs. You might try to write one of them John Lewis checks on my money, man. Let me get your name, man. I don't know now. I'm going to try. I got my main man from This Is It into the game last Saturday. He came up to me and just grease all on his hands when I went out to This Is It and shook my hand and told me thank you. But you got to give me your real name. Liz, get his real name and his phone number, and I'll do my doggonest to get you in the game. I can't do this for everybody. But see, this is a captain.
This is a captain in the underground posse. Kevin, Doraville, you're on News Radio 640 WGST.
How's it going, Ralph?
Kev, I'm living large.
That's good. I heard your comment about Nashville, and I'm from there, and I just had to say, figure out which place you were talking about up there.
Yeah, a buddy of mine, and his girlfriend, well, my ex-old lady and his wife, were both like classmates up at Spelman. And so those sisters kind of stick together. And when they got married in Macon, they went back and lived in Nashville, where he's from. His name is Michael. I don't know what Michael Washington, that's his name. Because her name is Cherie Washington. I forget his last name. It's Michael something. But he moved to Topeka, Kansas. But right before he moved to Topeka, he took us all around Nashville. We went to some barbecue place up in Nashville that served pork shoulder. That was, and I slipped, man. I ain't going to tell you no lie. I slipped and ate some. I don't know.
What sweats was it?
That's it.
That's my second cousin.
All right. You take that shoulder. They don't even put it in anything. They just like scoop it out and throw it in some foil and wrap it up.
That's right.
And you take it and you put it in your oven and you just lay out foil on your oven and you go in and you like reach in the oven and eat with your hand. You know, just all night long, drink a little brewski, go in there and eat some shoulder.
That's it.
And he took us to a lake somewhere near
there. It was Old Hickory Lake.
That's what it was.
That's it.
It was kind of funky because a lot of them hillbillies, them dark-haired, stringy-haired Tennessee white folk. white folk in Tennessee look funny, man. I'm serious, I have gotten used to white folks in Georgia. You know, you can get used to the red hair and the freckles and the red neck and the back and the rebel flags. But when you get to Tennessee, they look like that dude on that sausage package. You know, they got that black hair with them pointed hats. I'm serious. And most of them got rotten teeth. Most of the white folks in Tennessee I saw had rotten teeth. What's the deal?
Well, see, the thing is, because the best dentists are coming from Meharry, and they don't want to go to Meharry.
Oh, okay. Right. They would rather go toothless than let a black man put his hand in their mouth.
That's
I got
right.
you. Nashville is beautiful. I have an aunt that lives there. My uncle passed recently. His name was, do you know the Williams?
Well, which one?
His name was E.T., like the movie E.T. He's a big-time Q, Omega Sci-Fi man in Nashville. Nashville is a Q town, as a matter of fact.
Name's not familiar, but...
Yeah, his daughter was Miss Tennessee State one year. She's living here in Atlanta. My cousin's name is Sharon Fleetwood. She's a big-time environmentalist, big-time PhD in environmental something. She the one that'll lock you up if you dump out some oil or something.
Yeah. I know about her.
Yeah.
That's what I do down here.
Okay, she's kind of short. She's not short, but she drives a monster ride, Miss Tennessee State. You know she got to be bad. She's Miss Tennessee State. Although one year they had a bisexual that was Miss Tennessee State. You remember that year?
No, when was this?
Oh, well, see, you 10 years younger than me, man. When I was in school, man, Tennessee State was legendary for that. They had a dude that was Miss Tennessee State. I'm serious. With capes and long fingernails. I mean, a homosexual was Miss Tennessee State. I think it was 1969 or 70. Maybe some old Tennessee State grads. Maybe Joe Gilliam will check in. Or Jefferson Street Joe will check in. But I love Nashville, man. I had a good time. I never forget one time I was at Morehouse. I was a sophomore. No, I was a freshman at Morehouse, and this was my first band trip. And we went to Nashville to play Fisk. And I was looking forward to going to Nashville. Been there several times, but I was looking forward to going on the bus. When we got there, man, the smell of the coal, because everybody up there in Nashville was like burning coal.
Yeah.
Had like coal stoves and got off the bus. It was like gagging and choking me. Then I got used to it and I looked over the distance, man, and my homeboy, his name was Skeet, but he was pledging Q that year. And it was like the word had got back to Atlanta that it was like killing him, you know. You know, it was brutal in those days.
Yeah.
Kind of like the movie School Days. But anyway, I looked over the horizon and they were coming through, man, singing this song. Sons of blood and thunder, we shall not go under marching. You know, I said, oh, man, I got to be a Q. We went into the dining room, and this is no lie, Kevin. We went into the dining room at Fisk University at 5 o'clock in the morning because the bus got there early. You know, we left Atlanta about 10 o'clock. We got to Fisk about 5 o'clock in the morning. A four-hour trip took us about 8 hours. But we got to Fisk. It was 5 o'clock in the morning. And the first couple of sisters that staggered into the dining room for breakfast looked over and they saw the bus and it said Morehouse. And he looked and he saw all those dudes in the band. And they had like rollers in their hair and no makeup on and paper sacks twisted all. You know how sisters look early in the morning. You know how the black women look early in the morning. Man, they ran back in the dorm and put the word out. Morehouse. The Morehouse men are here. Man, they came back over into the dining room at 5 o'clock in the morning, man, dressed like Sunday go to meeting church, man. Man, we was scooping like I don't know what, man. We was scooping up like pelicans, man. And the first thing I did was I ran to my homegirl, went over to the dorm where my homegirl lived, and hit the buzz, and she was like the baddest girl in the dorm. So when we got her down, we said, hey,
We here turn us on, so, you know, it's like the Atlanta Club. Man, those good old days, man. You got me thinking about Nashville. Oh, man. Hey, appreciate your call, Kev.
Love your show. Love
all right,
your show.
All right, man. Appreciate you checking in. Got me reminiscing, man. I can still remember that date, man, in a hot tub and that jacuzzi. Ooh, that booty.
The time was 6 o'clock on the swatch. Watch, no time to chill. Got a date. Can't be Nashville. The girl is gonna do me.
Tennessee State.
To the jacuzzi.
Fist. Yeah. Pearl High.
Smack it up, flip it.
Jefferson Street.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Hi, everybody. Neal Boortz. Tomorrow, the Neal Boortz program ends with an exciting, wonderful Flush the Line session. You won't want to miss it. It is Atlanta's best radio. Flush the Lines tomorrow, the Neal Boortz program, 9 to noon, right here on News Radio 640 WGST.
After purchasing a home, most home buyers have little money left for emergency repairs. That's why R.S. Andrews created Peace of Mind, a home service protection plan.
Here you go. Bam! Ralph from Big Hill. Thank you for doing the business at Meat World. Bam! Thank you for doing business at Meat World. Bam! I looked around. They had pigtails, hog maws, oxtails. They had every kind of meat you can think of. That's why they're called what? Meat World. All right. They got chicken breasts for 99 cents a pound, beef ribs for 89 cents a pound, chicken wings, buffalo style, 43 cents a pound, fresh. And they've got that perch and that flounder breaded filet, 89 cents a pound. And you say, Ralph, dog, all you advertise is food places and this is it, and Savannah crab, and you know, and crickets. Hey, everybody's got to eat. And don't eat that food that floats. Get you some meat from Meat World. Meat World. Meat World.
Hi, I'm Rod Gant. A new year and a new era for the Atlanta Braves, and a new home, too. Now, with Braves Radio, is 640 WGST.
Telling y'all all my personal business about my trip to Nashville, Tennessee. I love Nashville. Well, y'all wait till I tell you about that time I went to Baltimore, to Morgan State. When I was in school, I must admit, I partied. You know, I was revolutionary. I was revolutionary, too. But I went to every major black college in the world. I'm serious. I even visited my main man, Otis Sistrunk, at the University of Mars. But Tennessee State, man, I'm telling you, Tennessee State is a monster. It's a big, 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 big school, you know, big school. But one thing that amazed me on all of my trips all around the country to different black colleges, it never ceased to amaze me that all institutions of higher learning that I went to for black people, with the exception of Morgan State in Baltimore on East Cold Springs Lane, that's the only black institution of higher learning that wasn't in a ghetto. Nashville, you had to go through the Pearl Heights Projects, or Pearl Projects, whatever they call it. Isn't that right, Jack? You know anything about Pearl High?
Yes, I know about Pearl High School.
You know anything about that bisexual that was Miss Tennessee State that year?
Exactly.
You know, I see.
No, it wasn't really Miss Tennessee State.
But, okay, he turned out homecoming.
Yeah, he would turn out the
football games
at halftime.
Okay.
Wearing all kind of fancy outfits that he made himself.
His name was
Terry.
Are you serious?
It was Terry.
Okay, I remember this. Now, we're the exact same age, and this was like legendary. In those days, you didn't get Negro news through the radio or newspaper. It was like word of mouth. And the word had come down to Atlanta that they had one at Tennessee State that was Miss Tennessee State. I heard he'd go to the top of the stadium and do that circle snap and three Z's and open up a cape and have on tights and all this old kind of stuff.
Exactly. Everybody would look forward to seeing Terry make his grand entrance.
That's right. That's right. Boy, I tell you, we are something else, man. We are some crazy people. And in those days, Tennessee State had some monster football team. I mean, y'all had Claude Humphrey, Turkey Joe Jones, Jim Marsalis, Lynn Dickey, Eldridge Dickey. That was his name. Vernon Holland, Jefferson Street Joe. I could name them all. See, I used
Too
to
tall
be
Jones too tall. Right behind that.
Right behind. See, Tennessee State put out like back-to-back tight ends for about 6 years. Turkey Joe Jones, Too Tall Jones, Claude Humphrey, and the boy you just named, Cold-Blooded.
Mm-hmm.
Cold-Blooded. Tennessee, that was true. It was right. That was a homosexual. He used to turn out the halftime, I tell you.
Exactly.
Now, Morehouse, we had some, but they weren't allowed at halftime, if you know what I mean. Did you attend Tennessee State?
I was there from 68 to 72.
68 to 70 is the exact time I was supposed to be at Morehouse. I had an extended stay, though. What was your major, man?
Major agriculture.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that was state school. That fits, you know. That fits. We used to tease y'all in those days. We used to kid
folks about agriculture, brother.
That's right. We accepted that tease, and we call ourselves the swinology major.
But this guy who went to my high school, who happened to be white, he was like the best in the city. His name was Dean Nations. Once upon a time, Dean Nations got a scholarship to the University of Tennessee, and he majored in agriculture. Now, he's a millionaire. You know what he works with?
What's that?
Soybeans.
Is that right?
Straight out of Tennessee, you know, in school. He's an agriculture major, and he makes billions of dollars dealing with soybeans. I said, man, I mean, if somebody would have sat me down and said, Ralph from Ben Hill, like the movie The Graduate. You remember the movie The Graduate when they had Dustin Hoffman, and they said, one word, plastics. If somebody would have sat me down and said, one word, soybean. I'd have said, man, you crazy, you know?
Well, back then, they were looking at soybeans as being one of the miracle crops.
They were, they were. The Japanese were talking about crossing soybeans with kudzu and feeding the world.
Exactly right.
Hey, man, good talking with you, Jack.
Good talking to you.
All right, we got another Tennessee State. We got the Tennessee State. Tennessee. Let's go to Tennessee State. Let's go to Ron in Decatur, Tennessee State. We talking about your alma mater.
Hello, Ralph. How you doing?
Living large, Ron. You a Tennessee State man?
Yeah, man. Sixth in 1967, by the way. It's kind of old time, but we had the powerhouse football under John Merritt.
That's right. John Merritt. He's one of the greatest of all time.
You got that
Eddie
right,
Robinson, though. John Merritt, and Jefferson Street Joe's dad was like an assistant coach or something, wasn't he?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Uh-huh.
Right.
See, what happened was, when I was there, I was there with Claude Humphrey and Ed Tuttle.
Ed Tuttle Jones and Claude Humphrey. Claude was cold, man. Claude used to tape up his ankles and tape up his calves with that white tape, and he was already bow-legged, and he come out there on that field. They made a rule in the NFL that was directed deadly at Claude Humphrey, and that was that head slap rule.
You got that right.
He used to come off that line and bam, hit that helmet, man, and ring that bell, knock Jeff Van Note all crazy.
Well, you know what? See, I was a wide receiver there.
Oh, okay.
And what happened was we had the scrimmage against that guy.
Okay. and Claude and them come across that line, man. He was serious, man.
The coach didn't have to tell us to run 50 yards in a big hurry because we wanted a big. When that guy started coming, it was time to leave.
I know it was, man. Tell us about Jefferson Street.
It was sad to go, boy.
Tell us about the street itself, Jefferson Street. That's a historic street, kind of like Auburn Avenue is to Atlanta. Jefferson Street is it still Jefferson Street?
No, it's Merritt Boulevard now. They changed the name of it.
Is the vibe on it still? Is the vibration still the Jefferson Street vibration?
Yeah, the vibration still the same. We used to hang out there on the fence in front of King Hall.
Yeah, yeah.
And man, we just hang out there in the summertime, watch it, and we used to watch over at WRC.
Right.
And boy, I tell you that now that brings back some old times.
Now, what about your interactions with Fisk? Tell me about the relationship that y'all had with the Tennessee State brothers and the Fisk sisters, or the Tennessee State ladies and the Fisk dudes.
Well, I'll tell you, see, I went to both schools. I went to Fisk graduate school, see?
Okay.
So I got to be a little careful what I say about Fisk.
You know, now, this is what I heard. This is like the dirt on Fisk. They used to say, this is the street committee now, you know, the street committee is them Negroes, but they used to say that at Fisk University, all the women up there were like high yellow, and all they wanted were doctors from Meharry.
No, that wasn't true.
Okay, because Meharry.
Hey.
Okay.
Hey, see, think about it. See, what happened to you, that was in the daytime. But see, they used to go out of College Hill and party with us at night.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
They didn't have nothing to do. See, after class, they all banged down our way on Saturday night.
What about the projects? What kind of relationship did y'all have with the block boys from Pearl Project? That was rough, man. That was rough.
I went to Pearl, too.
You went to Pearl High? Oh, you from Nashville?
Yeah, I'm from Nashville.
Oh, okay.
Right, man.
Well, you're a Nashville man, then.
Yeah, man. I'm right from Nashville. But I'll tell you something about Pearl, though. See, you okay, you know, as long as you knew you in the neighborhood. But if you you wasn't one of the block boys, it was not the best place to be at night, you know.
I'm going
to
tell you exactly what happened to me, man. I did not perform well in physical education when I was in Morehouse because I was in the band and they used to call us like pretty boys.
Uh-huh.
But the night that we played Fisk, it was a big fight at the game and all of that. Fisk got that little football field on the side of the gym with that little half of stands. You know what they got over there.
Yeah,
Fisk.
Yeah.
Well, it was a big fight over there, and I had to protect Miss Maroon and White with my bass drum.
Yeah.
But anyway, man, after the game, it was a party at the Holiday Inn downtown.
Yeah, down there on 28th, what, 70th, what, 8th Avenue, wasn't it?
We started out walking and wound up running.
Y'all walked through there?
Yeah, we walked through the Pearl High Projects on the way to downtown. Man, I ducked in the phone booth, and I was doing like Maxwell Smart, like I was calling somebody on the phone booth while they was kicking on some Morehouse booty, man. And I ran all the way downtown.
Hey, Ralph.
I'm serious.
Hey, Ralph.
Yeah.
Was Mohunt head coach there at Morehouse Inn?
No, we had Coach Darlington, Henry Darlington. He used to call him the Tiger.
Yeah, yeah. I was there when I came to Atlanta, I worked at Morehouse.
I think when you were at Tennessee State, we had Duke Foster.
Then first it was Coach Forbes, Duke Foster, then Darlington.
Yeah,
it was Darlington. I'm sure it was Darlington in those days because one of my main men got into a big scrap with the coach. By
you know, one of the funny things about it, when I came here, that was the first job I had when I came to Atlanta was Morehouse.
What about that black college experience? It was great, wasn't it?
Hey, man.
Is it real anymore? Does it mean anything anymore?
Nah.
Doesn't mean nothing.
Nah, it's not the same school. It's, you know how it is. They want to integrate it, and they virtually just about shot the school to pieces. Because, see, most of the art came out of, you know, up Chicago, Detroit, New York.
Yeah.
Man, it came down there. That was a melting pot, man. That school was, it ain't like
hot. Hey, appreciate your call, Ron.
Hey, Ralph. Hey,
yeah. All right, thank you. Taking me down memory lane, making me want to go back to school. I think I'm going to enroll over there at AU, take me some graduate courses and things. And, you know, when I look at all of the sisters that I used to deal with, the average age, if you put the average age of every woman that I ever, you know, was friendly with, that age would be 19. I'm serious. That's all I'm used to is 19-year-olds. I'm serious. 19. I'm serious. How old are you, darling? 19. That was my age and things. 19. I'm going back to school. Got to get me a degree in talkology.
Tom, a couple of weeks ago, I bought a pair of earrings at the Shane Company.
Yes.
I walked in the store. It was so crowded, yet I was able to get good personalized service. How can you do that?
We are constantly working with our sales team, and it really is a team. They're not paid on commission. Everyone works together. And we're really stressing product knowledge and at the same time paying attention to the customers, to what they really want.
And I knew nothing about earrings or diamonds, and I had three different people help me with that.
Well, I'm glad to know that the service that we're striving for, you received. And we really make an effort to treat all of our customers properly. Remember, we won't be beat in price, and I guarantee it.
The Shane Company on Wendy Hill Road, the first exit north of the perimeter on I-75. Go west at Wendy Hill. Open Monday through Friday till 8, Saturday and Sunday till 5.
Okay, that's it for our show.
No. I got to do a Branch Pennington commercial, and I'm going to talk to Robert in North Atlanta, and then I'm out of here. Now, this is a commercial word from our friends at Branch Pennington and Associates. Their telephone number is 843-2626. Listen, I don't care what your real estate need is, my posse. You at least need to own the property where you live. If you're looking for some rental property, if you're looking for some commercial property that you would like to develop, let my friends at Branch Pennington and Associates take you by the hand. Lovely Christy Pennington. My main man, Rick Branch, at 843-2626 are professionals. I'm talking about upstate high qualified, you know, big degree type real estate people. Not your brother-in-law, sister-in-law's cousin who's selling houses off the coffee table. But Branch Pennington and Associates have a first-class office. They have listings all over town. And they're going to be featured on the front cover of the Atlanta Tribune coming up real soon. And they got a big article coming up. Hey, people all over the country are writing about my friends at Branch Pennington and Associates. So get them on the phone, 843-2626. Tell them you want to rent. Tell them you need to own or you're trying to buy something, all right? All right. It's got to be better. Listen, I'm going to be out of here until Tuesday. But in the meantime, I got time to talk to my main man, Robert. Let's go to Robert in North Atlanta. You're on News Radio 640 WGST.
Ralph, how you doing?
All right, Bobby.
Look.
Yeah.
You were in the band at Morehouse?
Man, I played bass drum. Bass drum. I invented this drum time. This cut. You remember this cut by Archie Bell and the Drells called Tighten Up?
Yeah.
And you remember the jam by James Brown called Cold Sweat?
Oh, yeah.
Man, I used to play this drum time. Boom, ka-doom, doom, ka-doom, doom. It was called Cold Sweat. We used to turn out every city we went to. I'm serious. I was in the band 2 years. The only band that we couldn't smoke was Tuskegee's band, and they had Lionel Richie and the Commodores. And Morris Brown had Brick, had Rick Ransom and all them other boys in that group. They called themselves Hellafonalia. Now they're Brick. I don't think they're together anymore. But we were in the bands together, man. I had a contract with Motown to play drums, man, but I said, no, I got to talk on the radio. I was in the band, seriously, though, man.
But look here, let me ask you this. What do you know about the baddest band in the land?
The baddest band in the land, I'm going to tell you the truth, when I was a little boy, the baddest band in the land when I was a little boy, without a doubt, was Spam U. But now the baddest band in the land is Southern.
Well, no. Let me ask you this. Where does Grambling fall?
Grambling, all right. But all right. Southern Smoke. Southern brings smoke. Grambling is good for Coca-Cola commercials and everything, man. But Southern, they got them girls with them camisoles and them parasols. Oh, man, you know what I'm saying. All right. You won't have me to kick around. All right. They're taking Neal Boortz to Florida. Nancy Zintac is going to Florida. Tom Hughes. Everybody's going to Florida. Except me. I'll be here. Got a Hawks game tomorrow and a Hawks game Saturday and then a Hawks game Monday, and I'll be back here Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday. You might as well get used to it, my posse. 3 days a week, that's all they're paying me for now, you know? They cut my check, cut my time. Oh, Lord. They won't even put my picture in the paper with Neil, you know? Oh, man. But anyhow, what we need to do is crystallize our thoughts and bring our ideas together here on the Talk How You Like Underground Posse. Take advantage of the time that we do have. It's been my pleasure to be your servant here tonight. As always, in parting, I wish you love, peace, and don't do as I said do. Do as I do do, my posse. Live large and prosper.
Let's get out of here.
This is Head Coach Bob Weiss, and you're listening to the radio voice of the Atlanta Hawks, News Radio 640 WGST, Atlanta.